everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel ECA tutorial. So as per the last class, even this class we will be doing and the next topic, that is the Kirchhoff's laws and very important law which is important for exam point of view. So first let us look on to what about the Kirchhoff's law. Who invented it, how it came, what it is useful and all. So first of all, as shown in the slide, Kirchhoff's circuit law are two equalities that deals with the current and potential difference, that is known as voltage. So this Kirchhoff's circuit law, it is mainly dependent on current and voltage. So we in the formula itself says, so V and I, so between these two it deals. Next, in the lumped element model of electric circuits, they were first described in 1845 by German physicist Gustav Kirchhoff. So this was first invented by, and so the name it came, how it came in, the inventor of it named as Gustav Kirchhoff, by him he invented this law. So this law is named as Kirchhoff law and it was invented in 1845. This is generalized the work of George Ohm and preceded the work of James Clerk Maxwell. So this was firstly done from George Ohm's, this law was then preceded by the James Clerk Maxwell. So now it is widely used in electrical engineering. So that is why it is called as Kirchhoff's rules, or it is also known as Kirchhoff's law. So these laws can be applied in the time and frequency domains and form the basis for network analysis. So this laws can be applied in the time and frequency also. So to form and circuit, so to analyze the circuit, we can apply this law and use it. So now let us look on to what the Kirchhoff's law states. So this law states that for any anode junction in an electric circuit, the sum of current flowing into the node is equal to the sum of current flowing out of the node. So as this law states, which means an electrical circuit. So here you can see the electrical circuit, in an electrical circuit, so in any electrical circuit, so if you take this figure here, you can see this figure, right? So in this figure has shown, here there are incoming currents and outgoing currents. So as the law states, the incoming currents are equal to the outgoing currents. So this incoming currents are equal to the outgoing currents. So the algebraic sum of the currents in the network of a conductor meeting at a point is zero. Then this node, so all these currents are meeting at a common node, so that will take it as zero. For all this current, this is the common node, so this will be taken as zero. So here you can see the current here, I2 plus I3 mean incoming currents I2 and I3 will be equal to I1 I4 outgoing current. So incoming currents will be, so incoming currents will be equal to outgoing currents. Okay, so this here you can see the n here, this is the number of the total number of the branches with the current flowing towards or away from the nodes. So this is the n we will consider. So these n mean where the current are flowing, incoming current or outgoing current, but this node will be represented as n. So there are three laws in Kirchhoff's law. That means a hot solid liquid or gas under high pressure gives off continuous spectra. A hot gas under low pressure produces a bright line of emission line spectrum. A dark line absorption line spectrum is seen when a source of continuous spectrum is viewed behind a cool gas under pressure. So till here it is the three laws. Mean a hot solid liquid or gas and hot solid or liquid and gas which is under the high which is given in high pressure, it gives off the continuous spectrum. So it gives off the continuous spectrum. Mean any liquid or any substance which can be through liquid, solid or gas, it is under a high pressure. So the output it gives off the spectrum. Then the hot gas. So here next is about the hot gas, but this hot gas will be under the low pressure. So this will produce the output has the bright line or emission line spectrum. So here an high pressure gas will produce in continuous spectrum. Here low pressure gas will produce an emission line spectrum. A dark line or absorption line spectrum is seen when source of continuous spectrum is viewed behind cool gas under pressure. When the hot gas, cool gas which is under pressure, when this cool gas is under the pressure, so this cool gas is under the pressure, so it is viewed behind the continuous spectrum. So this is a hot gas, but in this continuous spectrum, when this cool gas is found, that time this absorption line is seen. Absorption line spectrum is seen when the cool gas is under pressure. So of continuous spectrum is viewed behind the cool gas under the pressure. The wavelength of the emission or absorption line depends on what atoms, molecules are found in the object under the study. So this the wavelength of the emission or absorption of this line. So whether this wavelength is emitting or absorption, this lines will depend, this wavelength will depend on what atom. So this these molecules contains what kind of atoms, accordingly this wavelength absorption or emission depends. Then what atoms or molecules exist, what kind of atoms or molecules will exist, that depends upon the temperature or chemical explosion. So even in this we have seen what kind of, where all we can use this Kirchhoff law, advantages, and there are many advantages also in through this limit Kirchhoff law, but there are also some kind of limitations applied to this Kirchhoff law. First thing, so here it's a huge concept given, but to be simple and clear, first thing you can tell that is these Kirchhoff laws are not applicable for the highly complicated circuits. Okay, so what's given, let's see what's given in the first point, that is Kirchhoff laws are the result of lumped element model that we have seen in the first slide itself, and both depends on the model being applicable to the circuit in question. So this kind of model depends upon the model being applicable to the circuit. When the model is not applicable, the law do not apply. So when this model is not applied, then this law will not be applicable. So in the first slide itself, I have told you that the lumped element model. So the Kirchhoff law is a lumped element model. So when this model is not there, then this law also is not applicable. That is the first point. The next point says that the current law is dependent on assumption that the net charge in any wire junction or lumped component is constant. When I work, the electrical field between the parts of the circuit is non-negligible, such as when two wires are capacitively coupled. This may not be the case. This occurs in high frequency AC circuit where the lump electrical model no longer applicable. So this second point says that here you can see where in the lumped element model, so where this lumped element model is not there, there this law will not be applied, right? So the same way, in what all kind of circuits the lump model is not present mean. So here you can see in the AC circuits, so high frequency AC circuit, in those kind of what circuits, the lumped element model is not applicable. So that means we can't use this law, right? Where this high frequency AC circuit are present mean, whenever the current law here, it mainly depends upon the net charge. So what charge is flowing in any kind of wire or a junction or a lumped component, so that charge should be constant. So whenever the electrical field between the parts of the circuit, so between the parts of the circuit, the electrical field will be present. So that time these kinds of circuits will be non-negligible, mean it's not negligible. So that time whenever the two wires will be coupled, capacitively coupled, so that time there will be high frequency of AC circuit will be present in these kind of circuits. High frequency AC circuits will be present, high frequency will be there, so that time this lump element model will not be applicable. So therefore this Kirchhoff law will not be applied also here. So here they have given the example, in a transmission line, the charge density in the conductor will constantly be oscillated. So here you can see the transmission lines. So here the transmission lines are flowing. So here the charge density of this conductor will be oscillating constantly. So in these kind of circuits, this law will not be applicable. That is the second point. Next, if you see in the transmission line, the net charge in different parts of the conductor changes with time. In the direct physical sense, this violates the Kirchhoff current law. Mean in any transmission line. So here you can see the transmission lines. Here the net charge of different parts of the conductor. So the different parts of the conductor, its net charge will be changing. The net charge will be changing according to the time. So with the time, the net charge also will be changing continuously. So here it violates the current law, Kirchhoff's current law. Then one more is that the voltage law relies on the fact that the action of the time varying magnetic field are confined to the individual components such as inductor. In reality, the induced electrical field produced by any conductor not confined but leaked field are often negligible. So here in the third point you can see that the time varying magnetic field mean the magnetic field which varies with the time are confined to individual components such as inductors. So inductor are the confined individual component. So but in the reality, if you see, the induced electrical field produced by an inductor is not confined, but the electrical field which is produced by the inductor is not confined. But here it says the magnetic field which is varying are confined to inductor. Mean the magnetic mean the magnetic field are confined to inductor, but the electrical field which is produced by the inductor is not confined. So these kind of leaked fields will be often it be negligible. So modeling real circuits with lumped elements. So here you can see, so this third point is just simple but little difficult to understand. I mean the magnetic field will be confined to inductor, but the inductor produce the electrical field produced by the inductor is not confined. So here also we can't apply the lumped element model. So in this also Kirchhoff's law cannot be applied. So here we'll see an example so that you'll get a clear view about this Kirchhoff's law. So here we are considering a circuit which consists of three resistors and two voltages and three currents. First we have to look through what direction this current is flowing. Here they have given a loop direction that is flowing through an anti-clockwise direction. So first it is going through I1, then I2, then R2, then E1 and R1. Here also anti-clockwise direction. First we'll take the first law itself. The first law says that the clock incoming currents is equal to outgoing currents. So as said, here are only incoming currents, there is no outgoing currents. So incoming currents, it's negative here because it's an anti-clockwise direction. This is flowing through an opposite direction, so it is represented as negative. Then this, by applying the second law for the first circuit, we'll apply the second law. So for that, second law mean V equals I into R, which by substituting the voltage using Ohm's law mean V equals I into R. So here V equals I into R. So first we'll through this direction only we have to go. So R1, R2 and I2, because flowing through this direction, R2 and I2. It is given as negative because it is an opposite direction. Then we'll consider E1 plus E1, because it is E1, this voltage is in positive direction, plus minus. So it is in given as plus. Then again opposite direction, so minus R1 I1. Here completes the first for the first circuit. Then the second circuit, the same way will apply. So here for the second circuit also, first it will go to R3, I3, then R3, then E2, then E1, then R2, I2. But here you have to observe carefully is that E2 will be negative because it is in minus plus. But here it is in plus minus, so it will be positive itself even. No. Here minus plus because E2 is negative, so we know that. Here through negative it is flowing to positive, so it is also even will be also negative. Through negative it is flowing through positive, so it is minus. And then here R2 becomes plus because it is in positive direction, mean clockwise direction. So R2 will be positive. So as said, minus R3 I3, then minus E2, then minus E1, plus R2 I2 equals 0. So if you consider here, this as first equation and this as second equation and this as third equation, then writing together all these three equations will be like this. And here the same way plus into is minus, but is written in the different manner, that's all. But here what does the changes mean? Here we have taken out E1, mean voltages, we have taken it to the RHS part. In LHS part we have 1, 2, 3 in the mean, no, all three currents we are having, right? But only this third equation doesn't have the I1, the first current. So we'll write as 0, so which means it has 0 only, but we'll write it as a complete equation. Then if you assume that R1 will be 100 ohms, 200 and 300, R1, R2, R3, then E1 will be voltage, will take it as 3 and 4. Just assuming a problem kind of thing. So then what will happen? If you want to find out the current, how will you solve? So I will be equal to V equals I into R mean. I will be equal to V by R. So V is first voltage, will take it as first E1, then I1, I2. They have only found out I1 and I2. So here the first current I1, if you take, and for that R1 and E1, 100. So then you substitute to any of these equation, you can use this method, or you can also take this given values, and you can substitute to this any of these equations. So for this, or for this, or for this, any one equation. I think better you choose this second equation or third equation, because you have even E2 and IR three values also we are having. So you can find out I1, I2 and I3 also. So here I have found out for I1 and I2, which key is the value of 1 by 1100 amperes, and I2 is 4 by 275 amperes. So this is an solution for this equation. This is an assumption question. So thank you guys for listening to this presentation. I hope you guys understood. So if you have any queries, you can comment below in the box. And also if you're a new watcher, then you can please do subscribe this video, and also like this if you like this video, and also share this. So meet you in the next video, guys. Bye bye.